I'm going to tell you now is true. That is to say that it happened. In the summer of 1998, my brother Adam created an internet website to hunt down the truth behind strange and unusual events. Being a person of great compassion and realizing that it was the only way he was ever going to get back the $500 that he'd loaned me, he hired me as his lead investigator. My name is Derek Barnes. The job he gave me was insanely simple. I'd go out into the world and gather the truths behind strange, bizarre stories and post them on the site. Never actually cared that much about the assignments. I just needed a job, and, you know, it was nice to hang out with my brother. I was actually having fun with it until that night that I walked into that roadside bar. I didn't know it at the time, but nothing in my life would ever be the same again. You don't understand what I need.
Oh, if I had a dollar every time I heard that.
Look, Crystal, I'm not like the other guys that hang out in this dump. Whoa, did I just say dump?
What do you want?
Look, I've heard stories, okay, rumors about dancers who burned up on stage, then just poof, went up in flames in the middle of a lap dance. Have you ever heard anything like that?
Maybe. Why do you want to know about it? Occultresearch.com? So what are you, computer geek?
No, that's my brother Adam. I'm just a surfer trying to keep cornflakes on the table. My name's Derek.
Oh. Had a roommate used to date a surfer. Never actually had one myself.
You don't say. Just hold that thought, okay? This had better be life and death. Adam. Whoa, wait, slow down. What, now? No, I can't leave right now. Look, I'm about to close the deal on the exploding lap dancer thing. Oh, listen, I can hear that you're upset, okay? It's just I'm in the middle of something really special right now, and hello, you're really breaking up. Adam, I can't. Bye, I'll talk to you in a couple hours. He's your brother, he'll understand.
You want to do this thing or not?
Yeah, you bet. You got no idea what I stumbled into tonight. Adam! I'm gonna use the key, don't shoot me. And I believe we're all created differently. Feeding up the fish to succeed effortlessly. And this zombie. You should pay your power bill, man. Adam?
isn't even close to funny, Adam. Adam. Oh my God. Oh, no. No. Oh my God. Oh my God, Adam. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
So here I am, nearly 2 years later. If I'd have been smart, I would have just shut the whole thing down and walked away after Adam died, but there was something so unfinished and so unresolved that I kept the website running. Changed the name to Freaky Links and took on a partner. Still not sure that was the right thing to do.
All right, so you know what you're supposed to do, right?
Of course. I'm gonna go around the back of the barn.
The front.
The front of the barn and make sure nobody shows up unexpected.
And?
And you're gonna slip through the front and do your thing.
Are you sure you can handle this?
Come on, D, have I ever let you down? This week.
All right, look, just shoot me doing the opening crawl. We'll edit the rest of this stuff out later, all right?
All right, all right. Whoa, damn, too much face. Hold up. All right, there we go.
All right, you ready?
Hey, let's rock and roll, baby.
All right. Hey, I'm Derek Barnes. My partner Jason and I have come here as a partner.
Hey, how you doing? Nice to meet you. Oh, go, go, go.
My partner Jason and I have come here as a part of a Freaky Links investigation into the black market purchase of an occult icon. The severed head of the great Seminole War Chief Osceola.
Ooh.
We have extremely reliable information suggesting that the severed head, which is believed to possess supernatural powers, is at this very moment located no less than 50 yards from our vehicle. All right, the barn.
What?
Get a shot of the barn.
Oh, right, right, right. Okay. Here we go, baby. Ooh. Dun, dun, dun.
All right, back on me.
What?
God, forget about it. Let's just do it. Wait.
Derek, hold on, man. You know you're gonna need my help.
So as always, the Freaky Links team is determined to uncover the truth behind the strange and unusual, to answer the questions that have no answers, and take you with us. Here we go. Hopefully there'll be enough light to get a good shot of the... Wait. I hear voices.
Come on, Walter. We know this head's gotta be here.
There it is. The severed head of Chief Osceola. Whoa. The eye's open. Oops. Time to go. No time for windows.
Get in the Jeep! Go! Go! Don't stop! No!
Go! Grab the camera!
You gotta be kidding me. So, what happened next?
Well, then they caught us.
Mm-hmm.
And they killed us.
Very funny.
Yeah, you like
know, you
bit?
Two should start a comedy act. Sorry. It's not easy always being the one left behind, you know.
Well, I'll take you anywhere you want to go, sweet thing.
Lon, you know we can't risk that giant brain of yours out in the field. I mean, come on. You're the engine that keeps this train rolling. The sunshine of my darkness, the sugar in my coffee, you know that.
Really?
So, absolutely. In fact, I need you to pull some of those tricks of yours, tear into the severed head footage, see if you can see how they made the eyes move like that. Can you do that for me?
Sure, yeah, I can do that.
Thanks, you're the best.
have 87 new messages.
Looks like the Whack Pack has been busy. Maybe I made a mistake. Maybe I should have kept the website the way Adam left it.
You mean a dry academic wasteland of occult novelties? Occultresearch.com. Could he have come up with a more boring name?
That was my brother. Long on logic and short on inspiration. Take a look at this, will you?
Oh, that's really sick, Derek. What are you, stalking women at the ATM machine?
It's not me.
Yeah, what do you mean it's not you?
I don't own a bank card, and I've never been to that place in my life.
And what is it, a picture of Adam before he died?
Well, that's what I thought, but...
But what?
Well, according to the time code, that footage was taken the day before yesterday.
You're 100% sure this picture isn't you?
I told you, it's Adam. See that scar above his left eye? That happened when we were kids. I pushed him off his bike and it took 6 stitches to close the cut. Somebody's messing with my head.
Which means that this video is the result of some serious visual effects gear. Hollywood level stuff. I just gotta figure out the password so we can get into this protected website. What was that?
It's a made up name Adam and I used to call each other. You know, twin speak.
Twin speak?
Yeah. Adam and I used to always know what the other one was thinking. We'd show up at the same restaurants, finish each other's sentences. There was times that I would pick up the phone before it would even ring, and he'd be on the other end.
It's spooky.
Yeah.
What is that?
Croatoan? I had no idea what it meant. Hell, I didn't even know if it was English. So I decided the best...
Hey, what's up, man?
Oh.
Oh, hey. You're doing the Adam thing.
Yeah.
Oh, my bad. I didn't know.
No, that's all right. No sweat.
So you mind if I just hang out here for a second? Look, I swear, you don't even know I'm here. So just do your thing. I'll sit here nice and quiet. Not a word. Be like I'm not even in a room. Go ahead.
All right.
I'm like a piece of furniture. Chair, a table, Tupperware.
So they say that life is for the living, and I agree. But here I was confronted with a part of myself, a piece of my own flesh and blood that I had buried 2 years ago. And I didn't know what to do with those feelings, so I decided to share them with the one person I knew loved Adam as much as I did.
Rompistes las costillas!
Stop whining, it's not macho.
Maybe you should pick on someone your own size.
Derek?
So what's with this whole fighting thing, Chloe?
Some people do aerobics. I fight. It's great for relieving the body of stress.
Yeah, not to mention a few teeth and a couple million brain cells.
What about you, Derek? You still chasing things that go bump in the night?
Yeah, would you believe I actually make a living at that circus?
Adam never saw a dime when his name was on it.
Yeah, well, Adam wasn't about the money, was he? What?
Forgot what you two look like.
Chloe, have you ever heard the word Croatoan? You know the word, don't you?
Derek, just stay away. For both of our sakes, just stay away.
Look, Chloe, I know it's hard for you to see me. Chloe, I wouldn't have come here if it wasn't important. I found this on my computer. According to the time code, that picture was taken 2 days ago. That's Adam.
If this is a joke, it's not very
funny. No, it's not a joke. I had Landwehr imaging scans on the raw video footage. There's no sign that this has been tampered with.
What are you saying, Derek, that Adam's not dead?
I know it sounds crazy.
No, it is crazy, all right? It's a hoax. One of those internet freaks is screwing with your head. You should know that.
Something happened to me the night that Adam died. I had a vision, a flash of something horrible. I can't explain it.
You think this has something to do with Adam?
I don't know.
Okay, Adam was researching the Roanoke colony. They were a group of settlers brought over from Europe by John White in 1587. It was part of a story he planned to post on the website. The families were left behind in a settlement camp while John White sailed back to England for supplies. This was just a few days after his granddaughter, Virginia Dare, was born. The trip took nearly 4 years to complete, and when he returned, he found the camp deserted. 115 men, women, and children had vanished without a trace. The follow-up investigations turned up nothing. No signs of violence. No evidence that the colonists had been absorbed into any of the local Indian tribes. They had simply and completely disappeared. The fate of the Roanoke colonies has become the holy grail of urban legends, the first great American ghost story.
And the word Croatoan?
It's an island 10 miles east of the settlement. White found the word carved into a tree, and he concluded that the colonists had fled there for safety. Unfortunately, he never had a chance to go there. That's the official story, anyway.
And the unofficial story?
Adam was convinced that White's journals were incomplete, but he did find something on Roanoke, something so horrifying that any official record had to be wiped out forever.
Virginia! Virginia! Is that you, child? Virginia! Come to me!
Virginia Dare.
The local tribes believe she was an evil spirit, a shapeshifter sent back from the depths of hell. Adam became obsessed with this one particular passage he believed came from White's completed diaries. But dreadfully, in the stead of my granddaughter, there awaited for me something born not of man. Something fearsome.
Fearsome. What is all of this? The name V. Elsing mean anything to you?
Nothing.
I don't know why, but somebody's playing games with my mind. And I plan to find out who.
How?
start at the beginning. Keep the tape running.
Anything?
Harvard classics.
Why didn't you ever clear out Adam's things?
I guess I never wanted to accept the truth about what happened.
Adam, don't.
No, I promise you won't.
Adam, stop it. We're gonna be late for the movie.
Forget the movie.
Adam.
Chloe.
No.
Chloe.
Chloe. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'll check the bathroom.
No, I'll do it. It's okay.
You okay?
What?
I saw your face. You looked different.
You saw me?
Yeah. Just now, you were looking down at me from the upstairs window.
I wasn't at that window, Chloe. I never came near that window. It was a mistake bringing you here.
Oh, Derek.
It's like you said. It's a hoax. I'll deal with it.
Deal with what?
Whatever or whoever's doing this to me.
Look, you can't just shut me out of this.
It's my problem, Chloe. I'll
Derek, let go of me. You are not the only one Adam called the night he died. Adam was changing. I begged him to shut down the website, to walk away, but he wouldn't. Or he couldn't. He called me that night. He sounded terrified. He sounded
on the edge of something, and I hung up on him. So you can't shut me out of this. You're not the only one carrying his death around inside of you.
Yeah?
Hey, it's me. I tracked down V. Elsing. You know that name from Adam's notebook? He used to be a patient at the Woodrow Psychiatric Hospital in Baltimore.
So where's he now?
He was first picked up for disturbing the peace.
What do you do?
He was shooting out storefront windows with a pellet gun. The cops said when they found him, he was sitting on the sidewalk just waiting for them.
What happened to his face?
He went crazy last night. Attacked one of my guards. Took 6 men to take him down. It's amazing, considering he couldn't weigh more than 160 pounds soaking wet.
I need to talk to him.
No. It's way past visiting hours, Matt. The doctors would have my ass if they even knew you were in here.
It's very important.
Five minutes.
Thank you.
They're not human, you know.
Who?
The ones you're looking for.
And who exactly am I looking for?
Yeah, well, now that's the $6 question, ain't it? Tell me something, man. Did you ever wake up in the middle of the night thinking somebody was in your house? You know, heard a noise you couldn't quite make out. So you get up. You turn the whole damn place upside down because you gotta make sure your little world is still safe and sound. Still just the way you left it. That ever happened to you, Mr. Barnes?
Yes.
Well, now, suppose that all those times you thought you heard a footstep or saw something flash out the corner of your eye. You really did.
Like what?
Like something else. Something fearsome. They feed on it, the fear. Like sharks to blood. The only way to stay safe is to push that tub back down deep inside in your belly. Because the second you feel it, the second you let it rise back up into your soul, that is when they come.
What have you seen?
Just a flash. Enough, though. More than enough. Are you listening to me, boy? You only see what your mind can handle.
I don't understand.
Neither did your brother. Not at first, anyhow.
How did you know Adam?
It doesn't matter. Because they'll be coming soon.
He kept talking about them. Saying that they were coming.
Who?
I have no idea. He had the same glyphs tattooed on his wrist that we found in Adam's files. This is making no sense.
Look, it gets even crazier. I checked the date on Vince Helsing's admittance. Derek, it was the same night that Adam died.
ATM footage, the one that Adam was following.
Where did she go?
I don't know.
Adam?
What are you doing here?
Insomnia. I thought I'd get some work done on the Osceola screen grabs.
I have a better idea.
What are we looking for exactly?
Exactly? Not a clue.
How's Chloe?
Very angry. Can we zoom in tighter right here?
Must be strange seeing her again, being that she nearly married your brother and all.
Just get me in closer here, okay?
She's pretty.
Stop!
What?
There, on the wall behind the tub.
What the hell is that? Derek? Derek?
There it is.
What is all this?
It's a message.
From who?
From Adam.
Like some kind of language.
This doesn't make sense. Every wall, every room in the house, every opening to the outside world is covered with these things. It's almost like Adam was trying to protect something.
Why?
It's just a wind.
Yeah.
You all right?
Someone down in the yard.
Oh my God. We gotta get out of here.
Yours.
Go to hell, Virginia.
I want to know what's going on, and I want to know right now.
It's you.
It's the website. You're stirring them up, making them nervous. You keep pushing this, and you're going to end up just like Adam.
You mean dead?
Well, I know there are a lot worse things than being dead.
Whatever happened in there had something to do with this, and you knew it. Now tell me the truth. What does this have to do with my brother's death?
So that's my story. Exactly the way that it happened. I've kept his death buried inside me for almost 2 years. But now I need answers. A way to close the wound. I realize now that in the end, Adam had been terrified by something. A terror that ultimately drove him over the edge of sanity. Adam was my brother. My twin. He was my best friend. And there hasn't been a minute past that I have not thought about him or felt as if I failed him. I'm gonna post everything on the website, no matter what, and pray that you can help me discover the truth. And in the meantime, I'm gonna use Freaky Links as a way to help other people solve their problems. To find answers in a world overflowing with questions. Because just maybe, in the end, that's the only way I can find my own peace of mind. Barnes out.
Hello? Hello? Hello?
Hello, is somebody there? Adam? Your body free.